Hello, I'm pleased to participate in this conference and I wish to thank the organizing committee for giving me the opportunity to present my research on a young woman's legacy to Greek society. Today I shall talk about Eleni Topaloudi's case as presented in the Greek media. Her case is related to gender-based violence. Gender-based violence in its various forms is a diachronic, cross-cultural and cross-class phenomenon articulated as a sociopolitical issue of great significance, first by the feminist movements and later on by international organizations. Femicides, women's murders with gendered motives, have entered public discourse as offenses concerning the majority of the global population only in the last two decades. Both media and family environments have been held responsible for not giving a clear picture of violence against women. In combination with the juridical systems, they have been involved in the successive labeling of gender-based murders as honor killings, family tragedies, and passion love crimes. The topic of this study is the disclosure of a notorious femicide case in Greece, which challenges the prevailing views about the aforementioned role of the media and family environments. Resources used are firstly textual information about local discourse on femicides, gender-based violence and media, found in 51 items on the Greek web in 2020. And secondly, TV digital representation of the university student Eleni Topaloudi's femicide on the island of Rhodes in 2018, as presented in 12 episodes of an infotainment program of broad viewership, Truths with Zina, Star TV channel, 2018-19. The method used is content and discourse analysis and the theoretical background, systems theory, media theory, and gender studies. Gender-based violence is a violation of basic human rights, a global health issue, costly for national economies and threatening to democracy, individuals and families. It is a multifactorial phenomenon extending to many levels: immediate, emotional, symbolic, structural, institutional and cultural, diffused within and across cultures. Femicides in Latin America are legally recognized. Legislation in Europe on women's murders is gender neutral. Femicides usually constitute the peak of an abusive process that, even when reported, does not incur immediate arrest and is judged leniently in court due to extenuating circumstances. Legal adoption of the term femicide highlights social responsibility, contrary to the traditional perspective of honor passion crimes, limited to family private sphere and affecting social and stately tolerance and reduced sentences. In Greece, domestic violence and penalties for rape were firstly recorded in the Penal Code in 2006. The economic crisis in 2009 boosted hegemonic maleness attitudes in the family and amplified funding issues in welfare services. Rape, regardless of age, does not incur more than 20 years in prison. Stereotypical views and financial or social class interests are involved in the procedures of reporting, detection, and litigation. Criminal law is occasionally considered punitive and perpetrator-centered, without taking provisions for compensation for victims and their families. After Eleni Topaloudi's murder in 2018-19, a series of demonstrations took place. A public debate appealing for legal recognition of the term femicide was generated, albeit questioned by conservative media personas as being neo-Marxist and a feminist coinage. And Greek criminal law was officially amended to include sex without consent as rape. Here on the left side, you can see a selection of images found in the articles mentioned in this part of the study. On the right side, the poster reads, "No more femicides." According to textual resources for this study, media contribute to the reproduction of degrading social constructs for women. Overexpose or dramatize negative events, especially sex crimes, in news framing and priming. They are involved in indirect structural aspects of violence, with women underrepresented in their hierarchy. They are only one of the factors involved in the stereotypical representation of women, but they can be illuminating by properly guiding the public. TV is a unisex medium, essential to fanatical and not to occasional viewership. And TV in Greece produces polysemous, contradictory and stereotypical representations of women, especially in the broadcasts of the morning zone, aimed at female viewership and housewives. Tolerates sexist anecdotes and jokes in broadcasts of the morning zone and serials, and allocates reduced speaking time for women, especially in the state channel panels. The number of the Greek web textual resources showed an exponential rise in 2018-19 after Eleni Topaloudi's murder, and the global impact of the Me Too movement. Most texts are related to the left or center-left wing spectrum, the feminist movement, and certain international media. About 25% originate from campaigns and research centers on women's studies. The majority of the visuals and graphics in the texts in 2018-19 originate from activist incentives, representing violence as a systemic phenomenon instead of portraying it on a personified basis. Greek TV is mostly viewed with disdain in the related articles, and TV broadcasts are strongly questioned for their quality, as are their symbolic and discursive aspects. Nevertheless, TV remains a very popular mass medium in Greece, and in March 2019, programs of the Morning Zone averaged at 1% higher than formal news bulletin reporting. For example, infotainment show Truths with Zina was rated 13% nationwide, and in 2020 only its web videos related to Topaloudi's case reached approximately 400,000 views. The show displayed noteworthy persistence in presenting the case and similar issues, providing certain insights into their structural aspects, and also provides web uploads allowing viewers' comments. At the same time, covers current affairs drawn from police judicial records, embellished with other attractions, evocative melodramatic narration, and celebrity experts as guests. Is hosted by one of the celebrity journalists of the morning noon zone, and appertains to market-centered journalism, with celebrities and ordinary people posing as news actors. Eleni Topaloudi's femicide in Greek TV infotainment shows a case study. Eleni Topaloudi was thrown alive from the cliffs on a shore of Rhodes after being brutally tortured and raped by two young men, with one of whom she had a very short friendship. Her case brought to media spotlight issues that official bodies and social entities and agencies tend to overlook. Primarily mobilized activists and NGOs, women journalists, representatives from the legal field, and academics. It gained broad publicity in mostly privately owned media. According to scholarly research, media tend to provide dualistic representations of human behavior and reality. They do not produce new meaning. They constitute archives or apparatuses that reproduce, reinforce, translate, or transform existing gender-based arrangements of power. Infotainment shows are usually viewed by the least politically engaged citizens. Audiovisual content from episodes of the show was analyzed according to the following categories: panel members and guests, main themes, visuals, personality traits and labeling of the student, the perpetrators and their families, and vocabulary, technical, forensic, and related to the juridical handling of the case. Discussion about findings. The show Truths with Zina, jointly with Topaloudi's family, addressed major social and legal issues such as photo and cyber sexual bullying, non-consensual sex, psychological or structural obstacles to reporting rape, and suspected rings of rapists and blackmailers in local communities. Encouraged an unprecedented Me Too response in directly affected individuals and families by employing the effective power of personal story and addressing repeated pleas to offended women to come forth and testify, and maintained a distance from institutional inconsistencies, racist overtones, and psychiatric justification for the perpetrators' actions. Previous research emphasizes that institutional aspects of violence are more dangerous because they are gentle and invisible to both dominants and subordinates, and at an unconscious level tend to identify the latter with firsts, norms, gaze, and language. On a different note, the show blended objective coverage with sensational titles and narrative, and with a characterology reflecting dualities and gender stereotypes. And most importantly, showcased the murder mostly as a personal and family tragedy and a pathogenic social phenomenon with no associations to patriarchal views or practices. The initial controversy over public disclosure of details of the case and high exposure of the parents showed that open discussion about violence against women is still a major taboo for Greek society. Although they initially appealed for discretion, the parents launched an unprecedented for local standards dialogue with the authorities, magistrates, perpetrators' relatives, other abused women's parents, local communities, and media viewers. This type of media disclosure had the dramatic features of a public memorial service and litigation, in which parents, apart from mourners, functioned as detectives, prosecutors, whistleblowers, and defense attorneys for their daughter in an unreserved and assertive manner. They took the mission of vindicating the young woman's memory into their own hands, by going through various channels and engaging the general public in their laws. There has been a traditional role allocation between the parents, but also reversals. Both the family and the father figure, and subsequently the authorities, prevailed as protecting or failing to protect symbols. The major issue highlighted in this study was sociological, ideological, and psychological shifts in the new generation of families in Greece during the crisis, which searched for new ways of making sense and meaning, and possibly for new balances through off-axis alliances or conflicts with traditional systems or apparatuses. Regardless of being politically correct or not, such a mutually unorthodox but effective alliance was formed through the intimate encounter of the team of a light news show with Topaloudi's parents. Eleni Topaloudi's femicide has been the tip of the iceberg in matters of violence against women in Greece. The public handling of her case was supported by her politically engaged and socially adept parents, concerned journalists, and prominent legal experts. There remain the multiple silent cases of abused or murdered women who do not have the means or an emotionally supporting environment in order to be vindicated. Issues of empowering offended women's freedom and autonomy beyond victimization and legal vindication still remain open. The legacy of the femicide in question is that illuminating interventions in the heart of traditional settings by deeply concerned citizens can contribute largely to innovation and social change in violence matters.